Hi, I'm Reza, and with my team today, we're going to tell you about an amazing phenomenon, the floating water bridge. Let's see how it's done.
So we have two beakers filled with deionized water and connected to a power supply which can produce about 20,000 volts. Applying the voltage, a connection of water is formed. Now when the beakers are pulled apart, we will have a bridge of pure water defying gravity and hanging between the beaker tips. It lasts for hours and can be as long as 25 millimeters. We were first introduced to this effect during the 25th IYPT, which is an international research-based tournament for high school students. We continued our study at Medical Physics Lab at Sharif University of Technology, where Nima, Payman, and Professor Amjadi joined the team.
When we started our research, no one really knew what force it is that holds the bridge.
The phenomenon was first discovered more than a century ago by Sir Armstrong, but was not studied until 2007 when it was discovered again. Since then, many researchers tried to solve the mystery. But what holds the bridge? Why doesn't it simply fall? This was a very challenging question. Maybe it is the water molecules forming chain-like structures in the electric field. Many people thought so, but experiments disagreed. To find the answer, we did quantitative experiments, analyzed them precisely, and estimated the forces.
Having the exact values from our measurement, we could compare the result with the theories to see which one is in agreement. The outcome was quite impressive.
Finally, we found the correct explanation, and this was a breakthrough highlighted in Science magazine's news. We showed it is classical forces, the sum of surface tension and the electric tension, that hold the bridge against gravity. Still, there was much more to be found out, so we decided to continue the research. That was where Zahra joined us in the team.
We thought what else we can do to learn more about this phenomenon, so we came up with the idea of perturbing the bridge.
As a mechanical perturbation, we let some particles fall on the bridge and see its behavior. We tried particles of salt, sugar, and even metal. Metal is conductive, and salt changes water's conductivity, and therefore destruct the bridge. We also tried to perturb the bridge electrically. While doing so, Nima found an interesting thing happening to the bridge when subjected to a special kind of oscillatory voltage. We called it the dancing bridge. He also tried to experiment the bridging in a vertical setup, which has less geometrical complexities. We found out that in special cases, the bridge oscillates in different kinds of modes, although a constant direct voltage was used.
Well, that was the result of about 1 year of research performed mostly by undergraduate students. Our research, however, is to be continued. Thanks for watching.